start with you because I think what you're doing is amazing, and I feel like what my group is an incubator for artists who want to learn about all the different blockchain projects that allow them to become financially independent in the crypto economy. I think that's really what my main goal of my group is, to free people of the corporate model, which I think is broken, right? And I read your story. It's very fascinating because you are this amazing illustrator. And I think if people know your background and why you created Data NYC, then it all makes sense what your mission is. So go for it. Let's hear about your background and why did you start Data NYC? And what is it?
Yeah, sure. So, well, first of all, I'm Beatriz, the founder, and Judy, my co-founder. We started Data from the very beginning together. Judy was my client a long time ago. So she was very familiar with... What's that?
I was nice to you. I was not an evil client.
So you were buying her, you were a corporate client buying her art?
I was a director, I was a creative director in an advertising agency, and we hired Beatriz and her studio to do illustrations and animation and stuff like that. And we used to love their work, and
Yeah, so I started my career in illustration when I came to New York. I started working for the New York Times and other magazines and things like that, and then went into animation. And by coincidence, I just found this job at MTV at the time. It was really great, but it was my first exposure to animation, and I loved it because as an illustrator, you're by yourself. You know, you work in your house, you do everything is about you, your name, your work. But when you're working in animation, it's all collaborative, and the community was beautiful. It was really encouraging. Everybody loved what everybody else was doing. So that was big for me. I stayed in animation the rest of my career. Then went into advertising. And the main reason was because it was the best way, or the easiest way to keep the studio alive. I was against going into
advertising. There's a lot of money. A lot of money in advertising, right? I feel like the talent, a lot of the artistic talent has gone through creating commercials that no one watches.
Correct.
I feel that way.
We used to say at the agency that Bea's work was better than the finished commercials, that her illustrations were better than what we actually ended up doing with them. And I think it's fair to say that that was true.
I realized a few things. One, that I didn't own any of the intellectual properties of the work that I've done in 20 years.
Right. So then you can't even publish it on a platform where you have control over it. It's not allowed, right?
Sometimes you can't even post anything on social media or the process or anything. But also exactly what you said. It's like all that talent, all the time, all the love, all the everything that you put into it for a cereal box or some, you know, craft, like, you know, some stupid product.
Yeah.
It was, so to me, it was like, wow. For myself, it was like, if I just put all that time and everything for something that is actually meaningful, and
yes,
if we all did that, what will happen?
I have the same feeling. I have the exact, I'm on the same wavelength.
And, you know, you don't have a lot of options. And to me, what blockchain gives is an option, is an alternative to all of that. And what's more exciting is to create a business model that is actually, that the equation doesn't have advertising in it,
right,
or data in it, or not even a client